Do is to open up Songbook. Okay, and you can adjust the width to for your songs, any of the categories, subcategories. You can sort them by title, subtitle, key. And here you tell it where you want to go for your songs. Right now I have my songs. Here's my hard drive, and I have my songs on my OneDrive. Go down to Music Books, and here are where my songs are mapped. And everything I have in there is now right here on my hard drive, showing here and showing here. You want to visualize your song. It's got a couple different ways you can do that. Here's your editing view. Here is your print view. And you can add or take away any of the views that you want right there. Okay. I'll go here. Let's find a long song. And here you can see that it'll put it out two columns. Now, if you want to print, you just go up here and print and set it up any way that you would like for your printer. If you want to print a PDF, you would go right here and save as PDF. Okay, say you wanted to print a few songs, just highlight them. And then click on the printer, and here are all the songs that are going to print. And again, if you wanted to send them to PDF, you would send them here as anything that you wanted. Okay, and I don't want to do that. Here is your PDF file, and you can see you can scroll down, and your songs are in this one file. And you can print it, do it, whatever you like. Here's the PDF file right here. You can share it, email it, drop, simulator. You can edit. Anything you can do with a PDF file, you can do with this file. You could print it. So anything you wanted to do, you would be able to do with this. If you want to set it up, page setup, you can set up your page here, landscape or portrait. And here you have a few options. You can hide your toolbar, exit full screen, auto scroll. While you're playing, it'll automatically scroll the song that you're on. Your song chords, it'll show the chords or not. Here are your chords. Now, in the PC version, all the options here are down here. So, and if you want to change your key there, and just go ahead and change it, and you see it's changing there. Okay, and it won't save it unless you click save right there. Capable or without, and you can see it makes the editing there. Now, the Mac is quite a bit faster when you make changes on here. It's pretty instantaneous. And you see it right away. Same thing holds with the Chord Pro. If you put the chords over the letters, you don't have any formatting. And there isn't going to be any way to change this other than what you put down there. You can't turn it red or anything else. And if you do it in Chord Pro, you have options. From this screen, click up here, go to Songbook, Preferences, and here are your layout, general layout and print preferences. You can change anything here, your chorus, shade, bars, or indent. left-handed chords, tab, mark bass tone. You can switch the chord formatting, instruments, you can switch instruments, tuning, and then your layout. Here's your lyrics. You have foreground, background, your font can all be changed. Chords, same thing. Tabs, comments, highlights, and then your print screen you can set up here. Your margins, multiple columns, auto zoom, include your chords or not, and number of chords per row. So everything's set here. I'll just change something here so you can see what it looks like. Let's do the layout. We'll change the chords to, let's go green. Okay, and you see how the chords turn green. If this were not in Chord Pro format, you couldn't do this. Your chords would just stay the same color. Okay, so I want to go back, preferences, and I want to change that back to red, layout, chords, red. And I want them bold. Okay, and there you go. That can change because of this Chord Pro format, and it's very easy, and I'll give you the address for the link. And that's Songbook for the Mac. Kind of play with it, and you can see you have a few different options here. You can change your song folder. You can change the way you're viewing things, inline chords. And that changes it there. You can take the chords out if you just need to print it for music, and anything you do here will print. And here's your print right here. If you want to print, say I wanted to print my playlist, Ashton Park, I would just click over here, Command A, highlight everything, and then hit the print button. And according to how I've set up my print screen, that's how these songs are going to print out. And I've got 129 songs. Now, if you wanted to send them to PDF, you could do that right here. Save as a PDF. Let's save a couple as PDF, and I'll just show you what that looks like. We'll save that many. We'll go to print. Save as PDF. Okay, I'll just save it on my desktop so I can get it real quick. And you can enter anything in here you want. You say you wanted to put the playlist that it was. And if you want to be able to find it later. And might as well keep it consistent. Save. Okay, we're going to go to find it. We'll minimize this. And here is the file. I put it on my desktop. Open it up. See all your pages here and just scroll down. 18 pages. And here's how they look on your computer. And these are on one PDF file. Right here, if you want to scroll this way. Page 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And go to page 18. All your pages are there. From there, you can send them anywhere you want, or you could print them. Or you could even edit them. Mark them up, anything you wanted to do. There you have it. That's how to handle your viewing options and printing options and different screen options with Songbook on a Mac. So go out and make some music.